Hey guys, so today I figured we would clean out my bathroom. Not, I don't mean clean it, I mean like it is so unbelievably disorganized. This is like an every year kind of thing for me. I don't know if I'm alone in this. I don't think that I am. I was talking about this in my recent Vlogmas video too. I feel like when my like under the sink cabinets get to a certain level of like disorganization and messiness, I hit a point where I'm like, oh, whatever. And so I just start throwing stuff under there. Like I don't really think about where I'm putting it, and it gets worse and worse and worse. It just compounds. So I'm finally at my breaking point where I'm like, I can't find anything. And my blow dryer cord is mixed up and wrapped around like two other things every time I'm trying to blow dry my hair. So anyway, we're gonna finally organize it. If you saw mine last year, this is gonna be kind of similar. I definitely need to declutter and get rid of some things that I'm just not liking. So I stuffed them under there and I need to like give it a new home, give it to a sister, whatever. Especially like with skincare, hair care, stuff like that. If I'm not using it, it needs to go. So I've got some coffee today. I usually drink it black. Today I've got some peppermint mocha creamer in it. It's gonna be a good day. Let's go into my bathroom. I'm gonna show you what we're working with here.
Dealing with a little bit of cord action because I had to plug in my phone, but this is the area I'm talking about. So I've got two cabinets here, two drawers on either side, and then I also have all of this here that needs to be reorganized. Really, we kind of share, well, we definitely share this bottom one. It's mostly backups of stuff we actually use every day. I wanna make sure everything I'm using all of the time is within reach, like quick and easy access. Right now I have a bunch of hair stuff in here that's just rolling around and it's driving me bonkers. But I know what you freaks really wanna see, and you wanna see how bad it is. So let's just let you soak it in. Look at this mess. Ugh. It has been like this for like months. It's really embarrassing. So I cannot wait to see the after of this once we do all of this work. I'm not buying anything new to organize it. I wanna use what I have, but I just, what even is this? What even is that? So then, let me get this cord out of the way. This here is my hair care drawer, but it also has like skin care and stuff in it and contacts. It's just kind of a weird mishmash. This one is probably my most used drawer, so pretty much everything in here I actually use all of the time. But I definitely, there's some things I need to get rid of in here, so. And then here is my, like, this is what I was talking about, where the hair care just rolls around. There's no really rhyme or reason to it. It's nice to be able to access everything really quickly, but this is not gonna be the way it is because it's driving me crazy. Down here, I have like hair brushes, some sheet masks. I might get rid of most of these. I really don't use sheet masks much anymore. And I know I have sisters and nieces that would love those. I actually, this is usually full of washcloths. A lot of them are in the laundry. I need to wash them. So that will definitely be somewhere in a similar spot. Some speakers we use sometimes, etc. And then this is obviously problematic. This is like our backup drawer. So like we'll go to Costco and get, you know, a bunch of toothbrushes or whatever, and this is where they go to live, and I need to do something about this because this is insane. And last but not least, this mess. Used to be super organized. You guys have probably seen in here before. It is currently like a random amalgamation of things. So I cannot wait. Okay, I'm gonna try to take a few before photos so at the end, when it's organized, I can kind of show you them side by side. I know I love watching that. All right, so here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking I lay out a few beach towels because that is what is clean. Like I said, I need to do laundry. Don't get me started. I should be doing laundry right now. Anyway, I'm gonna lay out different beach towels, and each beach towel is gonna be a category. So all of skincare will go on one towel, all of what else, hair care, maybe have a third for like body care, and then one last one, a fourth for like everything else. So like tooth care, you know what I mean? Things like that, because there's always gonna be that miscellaneous category. So hopefully that will kind of take care of everything, because I think last time when I did this, I just had everything all over the floor, and it actually took way longer than I think it should have, and it was a little bit more difficult for me. So that's how we're gonna tackle this. We're just gonna see. We're just gonna see what we see. I got my biggest towel for skincare. Maybe I'll like split this towel in half and it can be half one thing, half another, because this is humongous. Like, all right, giggle if you must, but I'm just using hand towels to split this into two different sections for each of them, because I really don't have room for four beach towels to be laid out, but I think this is gonna work. So I'm thinking I'm gonna put skincare over here, I'm gonna put hair care here, and then body care, and then miscellaneous. We'll see if I remember that. I'm sure I'll do it totally the opposite. And while I'm waiting, I'm gonna pull up a YouTube video to watch, because, well, this is gonna be all sped up anyway, so. We'll be right back.
So I'm in my laundry room. I'm literally mid doing my like toddler's laundry. Anyway, I'm grabbing a cleaning supply to use because I wanted to clean out the drawers and everything. This is one of my favorites. I buy it on Grove. I don't know where else you can get it. Maybe Target, but I don't know. It's a little bit more of a natural brand. It's not totally natural, but this smells. It makes your house smell like you are the wealthiest person on the block. I can't explain it other than that. You have to smell it.
All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and clean all of this really quickly.
It almost feels like moving into a new house. You know what I mean? Like when everything's so clean like this, it's like, ooh, did we just like move in here? Oh my gosh, how exciting, new home.
So this is what we're working with. We've got skincare over there, hair care there. I ended up making an extra pile of just self-tanner stuff. I don't know how I ended up with that much, so I need to go through that for sure. And then I've got like body care and then miscellaneous.
I'm kind of thinking I'm gonna start by going through and pulling out anything I use every single day and making sure I put it in a place that's really easy to reach. Oh crap, I just realized I have all this skincare here that needs to go down there. I think I'm just gonna lift the tray in. A lot of that stuff I'm trying to use up, it's like almost gone.
So one thing I don't think I ever utilize well is this little cabinet. I usually put skincare in it, but lately I've been leaving skincare out. And I think that because there are plugs, I was never really using these plugs and my hair care tools always get messy down there. So I'm thinking maybe I put them up here and then it'd be easy access. I have a place to plug it in. Can't say that I've ever cleaned off my hair dryer, but here we are, now I have. So this can live there. That's nice. And maybe it'll actually force me to like wind it up every time. I also use this diffuser when I wear my hair, kind of like it is today, although today my hair air dried. So I'm kind of thinking I don't like this. So I'm like, well, maybe I'll put them in here so I can still access them easy, you know, because you can't shut it. So this drawer is a little bit thicker. Maybe I'll keep them in here because I think I used to keep them down here. And then whatever I end up putting up there, I want to make sure I leave room in the middle so I can access those plugs. But maybe this is my best bet. So hot tool wise, I have like one straightener and then one more curling one that's a little bit more tapered that I'm going to keep. And then I have two other curling wands I'm going to pass on. So these I'm gonna store somewhere. So if I ever need them, I know where to find them, but I don't need them to be accessible, you know? I might put them in my big drawers down there. So hair wise, a couple things I still do use. I like having a mirror like this so I can see the back of my head. And then like a little pick that I can, so I can change the part in my hair if I need to. And then a round brush and a detangling brush. So one thing I think would be nice up here is maybe my hair stuff. Since I didn't like it in the drawer, maybe this can be where I put like my hairspray, etc. I have this little tiered thing that I've used for, like I said, skincare, and it does just fine, but I could totally use it to be able to see all of my hair care too. So I've got some hair care in there. I have a handful of hair care products that are either totally empty or I'm just not using them. They need a new home. So those are gonna go. But I feel like that's really nice. I can see everything. It's not rolling around. I've got pretty much everything I would use for any scenario up here. I really don't need any other hair care products in this bathroom at all. So I've worked through a lot of the hair stuff. I do still have these products. Just feel like these were in one of my thinner drawers and it just was not working out well. So let me kind of separate it out a bit.
Headbands, my hair, clips, pins, hair ties, scrunchies.
There's my pearl pin. I've been looking for this for forever. This is that stupid Ponyo product that's supposed to make your pony like stand up more, and I have tried everything. It does not work for me. Kitsch is fast becoming one of my favorite hair care brands. They always have really cute hair products. I know they sell it at Ulta and I found some of their stuff on Amazon too. I hate these hair ties. I used to use them and they were okay. But now that I've discovered like the thicker, really nice hair tie that I love, like I said, you can buy it on Amazon. These work amazingly for my hair and they actually hold my ponytail up. So these are gonna go. So I also never use these. I always want to, but I don't. They don't hold my hair strongly enough. I literally have three hair ties right now. That's insane. I need to order a new pack of these. So this is a pin tin that Briogeo sent over with something. I don't know if they sell it or what. I don't need the gold one, so those can go, but I am gonna use this tin for my brown ones. That's perfect. And then they're not just swimming around in there. I know some people use like Tic Tac containers for this. There's all kinds of things you can use for pins. This was actually my wedding
barrette, so I'm definitely gonna keep it, but I kinda think I should put it like in my wedding box. All right, so the rest of these I'm going to keep. I think I'm gonna move like the hair pins into this smaller thing so I can see them a little bit better. So I figure I'll just sit down here and go through the skincare real fast. There's a lot of stuff that's just old that I've been using for a while and I've been trying to use up, but it's genuinely gotten old. This Pixi Vitamin C Tonic, I really have had for a while. I talked about this in my drugstore skincare video. This Alpha Serum can go. It's a little too strong for me. Some things are completely unopened. I'm gonna move with my other skincare in my office because they don't need to be in here until they're open, to be honest. My PMD, a lot of you guys asked if I still use it. I still use it like once. Honestly, it's kind of like every other week now and I do still like it. So I wanted to quickly go through these masks. I think I'm literally going to pass most of these on because like I said, I really don't use them. So Patchology is one of the few that I actually like. So I'm gonna keep these Hydrate ones. These are usually like, yeah, they're 5 minute masks. So like you could do it in the morning before going to work. Like how incredible. Brightening, I might do that. And some of these are just getting old, you know? Like I feel like I've had some of these for so long and they're just sitting here and I had already decluttered most of this. The skincare I'm currently using, it really is a weird mishmash because I'm trying to use so much up. I don't mind having it out on my countertop, but at the same time, it's kind of nice to not have out on my countertop. I'm a little bit torn here. So with these masks, I think I'm gonna actually put the other kind of masks I have open. So like ones that you actually put on and wash off. So that's one of them. The Sukari Baby Facial. This Belief one's a sleeping mask too. Maybe I'll put that in there. So I'm a little bit torn here because this, I can actually fit all of that in there and shut it, but it's also really busy. Like it's almost too much. So I'm gonna take a break from that and kind of let that simmer. And I'm gonna start putting things I use all the time in here. I started doing that earlier and obviously I got sidetracked. So one kind of different thing I use a lot is like a denture cleaner. I use it for the Invisalign that's in my teeth and I've never really had a home for it. So it is going to live in here. That's so nice to have a place for it. Because I'm an old lady, I also have my vitamins and things that I have to take every day. Can go in there. I've got my floss I use every day, my toothbrush and toothpaste. So everything kind of fits in here. It can actually breathe. Over here, I'm kind of thinking we do like my deodorant and things like that that I use super often as well. And I want them to be really quick to reach. So like the deodorant I'm using, the body lotion I'm using right now, dry brush, my contact case that I'm using right now, the contact solution I use. Adjusted a few things. I might like this better. So I turn this kind of diagonally so it actually fits. I have my reusable cotton rounds that I use with toner every night. And then the little mesh bag that you put the dirty ones in and then you just throw it in the laundry. This is nice. It's nice to have those separated because that was always floating around, but also I can still see everything. I can still technically access those when I need to. So somehow we still have all of this. I'm gonna go through really quickly all of this, pick out what I actually wanna keep and everything else is going. That's gonna have to be how this rolls because otherwise, this is gonna take forever. So like if you were curious, some of my favorite self-tanners, I think my number one favorite, the one I go to and it's foolproof for me is the Loving Tan 2-Hour Express. They also have like their regular. The 2-Hour Express, man, is a gorgeous tan and in my humble opinion, stays on days longer than this one does. And then some of these are just so, like I've had for so long, I'm like, ooh, I don't even know when I got that. So I think that this stuff works, but it makes my skin burn. It's the Ren AHA Smart Renewal Body Serum. Y'all, it makes your skin burn. It's an alpha hydroxy acid, so it really is exfoliating on a deeper level, which is why I don't want to get rid of it. And I don't think I've tried a product from Ren that I didn't like. And this line of theirs, like their Radiance line or whatever, is really good. So the idea of this, it has lactic acid, so it's good for like if you have those red bumps. However, I'm noticing a bigger transformation. Like I have all of these, like I have Emlactin, I have the Dermadoctor KP Duty. I stopped using these and it cleared up faster. The red bumps cleared up faster by just like exfoliating with like a sugar scrub or something like that every time I shower and then putting a really good body oil on. I'm telling you, it cleared up. Now it's not perfect and sometimes it'll flare up if I'm really hot, like if I just worked out or something. So that's why I don't really want to get rid of these because I'm like, I don't think any of these are bad and like Emlactin is what my dermatologist recommended for it. So, and none of these are cheap. So I think I'm going to keep them and just pull them out when I'm really feeling like the flare-ups are crazy. But again, I want to use them up before they go bad and anyway, so I'm going to keep them for now. That's, I guess, what I'm trying to say. So I bought an epilator. And actually, it's funny because Taylor Wynn had texted me when I was like posting on Instagram about buying one. And she was like, don't. It kills. Have you seen my video on it? And it does. It kills, you guys. But I still wanted to try it. And I will say, after the first few times you use it, you do get used to the pain. Like, you use it, like, let's say on your underarms. But the problem is, if you stop using it for a while, the benefits of it are that it's really pulling the hairs up from the root, and so it grows back a little bit thinner, slash it just, a lot of it stops growing back, so it's just easier maintenance. But it's still not perfect, and if you stop using it for months, then you gotta go back through the initial pain again, and it's kinda like you're starting over. So you really have to like stay regular with this to really see the benefits, and it's really difficult for me to do. So I'm gonna put all this back in the box, and I'm gonna keep it under there if I like really am feeling the itch, let's say maybe next spring, and I'm like, okay, I really wanna get into this, maybe. But for right now, I'm like, I need my distance. So I'm gonna put all this in the box so at least it's all together and it doesn't need to be out right now, you know? So I have feminine products in here. You guys know this is not sponsored by Lola, but I love Lola, it's all I use. So I have like all of my like Lola goodies in here for next month. And then I also have pregnancy tests because you never know. So I'm gonna go see if I can find like a container or two to help organize some things under there just from my other rooms in my house. Hold on.
Here, these I get from the Cosmetic Archive. They're really, really nice. They're actually made to fit perfectly in the Alex drawers, but I use them all over the place now. So I have a couple options and I'm thinking this might be a good one for organizing some things. I also saw this and I was like, that could kind of work nicely for putting things so that they're kind of slightly upright and you can see everything. So I'm gonna bring these in there and see if I can use them anywhere.
Okay, oh my gosh, these fit. And now I'm like, well, since it's holding them kind of upright, I could like have skincare in there if I wanted. But how, yeah, and there's even some clearance here, let me see. No, okay, so some things are too big. Yeah, I kind of like having my skincare up here if I'm being honest. I don't want my hair care in there. What else would I put in here that I would use? You know, I can't think of anything. This is just so nice. Oh, I could put makeup though. I was wanting to keep like a face of makeup in here. All right, so I just grabbed a box and anything I'm getting rid of, whether I am going to clean it out and recycle it or pass it on or trash it, whatever, I'm gonna put in this box to deal with later because I really got to get this stuff kind of out of my way, you know what I mean? Okay, so I think I'm gonna start with this one and see if it can help me stay a little bit more organized this time around. So like mouthwash, I know I use all the time. So those can go kind of in one compartment in the front, but they're at least corralled. These can go towards the back. So all of this stuff is now in this box, so I can put that maybe towards the back because I know I'm not gonna use it, at least not anytime soon. And with, I've got my sinus inhaler I recently got and I actually really do like it. They're kind of pricey. They were pricier than I thought. I'm gonna keep it in the box and I'll keep it in here. So when I need it, I know where to find it. The last few things I need to figure out is where to put my like hand towels. Again, the stack is usually much, much bigger and it will be once I'm done with laundry. So I want it to be somewhere. I use a different one every night. So I definitely want to be able to grab it. Maybe I will have to put it in here. So now I'm wondering if I could find something to put in here to hold makeup. Like I was saying, like a smaller thing. I don't need anything this big, I don't think. I found this little container. I think this would be like the perfect size. And then I can have these washcloths along the back. I previously put them in this caboodle, which was great. But I was finding that because it was the smaller one, I was struggling to fit really everything I wanted into it. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna go switch out what is in here and actually put it in here. And then I don't know what I'm gonna do with this caboodle. I'm gonna have to think about it. So I've got my makeup here I picked out. And I think I'm just gonna put it right there. It's nice that I can see everything. I need to get a little container for the brushes though. So a little unconventional, but I have this little like brush. This is technically for a sponge, but this could work for this and it can still kind of sit sideways. And then when I'm getting ready, I can just kind of flip it up. Actually, that's really nice. So there we go. The reason I'm kind of focusing and spending some time on this, I mean, you weren't with me when I was picking out the makeup, it took a while, but is because I actually am finding that I'm preferring to get ready quickly and in the mornings, like in my bathroom versus like at my vanity, which is in another room. So I'd rather have makeup I'm enjoying or wanting to try out in here so that I can get ready really quickly and easily in here. So,
okay, so I think I'm done. I'm gonna take you into each of the drawers, show you how I organized it. I mean, you saw a lot of along the way, but I figure I'll also show a little bit of before and after so you can see them in that fashion too while I'm talking about it. So let's start with my top two drawers, the things I use the most. So this top right drawer is my toothbrush toothpaste. If you remember before, it was very similar to this. It wasn't that different, but there were a few extra items that I just wasn't reaching for, so they didn't need to be right here at my right hip to grab each day. So in this left top drawer, I, again, only have things I'm using every day. So before, I had a whole bunch of hair stuff, a whole bunch of things just kind of thrown in there, no organization. It was really hard to find stuff. Now I have my deodorant, I've got my lotions and some stuff for my contacts I use every day, and my contacts case and a dry brush. So I love that, again, I can see everything in here and it's all very useful stuff. So in this upper cabinet, we have it organized. So if you remember before in here, I had some skincare, but I had like medicine and sunblock and just everything you can imagine. Again, all thrown in here, no rhyme or reason anymore. So now when you look at it, I've got on the left my hair stuff. So these are things, they're not gonna be rolling around in the drawer like they were before. They're stuff I'm actually using. And then on the right side, I've got all of my skincare that used to sit kind of right near my sink and out all the time, but it kind of bothered me that it was just always out and it wasn't necessarily a beautiful thing to look at. And I like clear countertops, so I like having it in here. I've got a bunch of stuff I'm using, nothing that's expired anymore. I've also got my little cotton rounds and stuff here too. So in this top drawer here, so before, you may recall, is where I had all of my hair stuff and it was all rolling around in there. And I had like contacts up here. I've got all of the makeup I'll be using over the next few weeks in here, and I'll probably switch this stuff out from time to time. Got my brushes I would need. And then I also have my hair stuff, and that was it felt so good to declutter that stuff. Now I can actually see what I have. It's all stuff that I actually like and use, and so it's not cluttered with stuff I'm never reaching for anyway, even though I like the way it looks, you know what I mean? And then I also have a remote for our TV, and then our just scissors are nice to have. It'll be washcloths all along the back there. So in this second drawer here, oh my gosh, this one wasn't in horrible shape originally. If you remember, I still had some masks in there and some hair brushes, so it's not totally different, but now it's a little bit more organized. I got rid of a lot of masks and things that I just wasn't reaching for ever, so now it's actually stuff I'm using. I cleaned out the hairbrush stuff, and then I also have the two hot tools I use the most organized and kind of pulled together in an area that, again, is easy to grab each and every day, but it's still out of the way enough that it's not tangling with everything else. So this drawer feels really good. I also threw the speakers we use sometimes. Tyler, we like to keep them in the bathroom. Don't ask why, that's just like always where they've lived. So this one's nice. I did not tackle this bottom drawer. This is the one that, remember, has a bunch of backups. Honestly, I just ran out of time today, so that might be a future project. So down here, oh my gosh, I don't know if it looks organized to you or not, but it definitely is. So if you recall before, this was a jumbled mess. This was the part, I think, of my bathroom that stressed me out the most, because I just had my hair dryer and hot tools and all those wires tangling with everything else under there. Over here, I have my feminine products, and then I've got a couple of things that I don't use as often back there, and they're back in their box and organized. My PMD skincare is all together in this bag. Some other hot tools I use from time to time. I've got sunblock here, and then all of my self-tanning stuff is gathered together. I loved using this little compartment thing here. So I've got my mouthwashes that I use from time to time. Again, easy access, they're right there. And then my like vitamins and things. This, you might giggle because it's like, wait, do you have dentures? Again, it's for my Invisalign. And then I have my extra contacts back there. I've got skincare that I do use from time to time. Like I was mentioning, the ones for like the red bumps on my arm, those are under there. The next cleanser, once I'm finished with that, that's already half gone, I'm gonna pull that up. Some anti-itch cream I really like from CeraVe, contact solution, and some deodorant wipes. And then this is actually my travel hair dryer that I don't use often, but it's there. I don't wanna get rid of it either. So I just feel so good about everything. Like, I feel like when things are in such a disarray, like this would be a space I didn't wanna be in. So I would do my skincare routine as fast as I could at night, because I'm like, I just don't wanna be around this mess. Now I'm like excited tonight to come in here and like take my makeup off and use my skincare that I can see everything. And You know what I mean? I know I'm not alone in that. And it's just stressful when it's disorganized. So now that it's organized, I'm like excited. And it's just those little things in life that bring me joy. I'm sure I'm not alone in that. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I love doing videos like this. I don't always film when I do this because I'm trying to gauge whether you guys are interested or not. Like I've said before, I like this type of video, so I don't mind filming them. Let me know your thoughts. Give this video a thumbs up if you do like these kind of organized with me style videos, especially as we move into 2020. I'm definitely looking at doing some more different video ideas, lifestyle videos on my channel, just to kind of breathe some different content out there in the ethos. But thank you for watching. I hope you'll subscribe to my channel. I typically do 3 videos a week, sometimes 4, and sometimes way more if it's Vlogmas season, where we're doing tons of videos throughout the month of December. So if you want to catch our Vlogmas series, I do half of them on my channel, half of them on my husband's channel, which is Tyler Travels TV or Tyler Braun. And so you can subscribe to him down below as well, and you can catch all of those. I hope you will, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.